Hi guys, it's Sean, and in this video, you'll find out some unconventional tips to pass your software developer or engineering job interview. Now, I'll tell you some tips from the other end, because the part of my job as a senior AI developer and machine learning engineer at BMW is to hire people like you who are watching these types of videos. Now, during my career, I've interviewed hundreds of people, so I decided to make a short video just to show you folks how to successfully pass a job interview. Now, for those of you who don't know, the interview process for software developers or engineers is usually divided into two parts. You've got this personal component to find out about your type of personality and to make sure that you're a right fit for the team, and then a second interview where there is a problem-solving interview, and you'll get a couple of tech questions which you need to solve. To get a job, you need to ace both interviews. Now, no matter how talented you are as a programmer, many companies will likely not hire you if you're just a shitty person and either insult your interviewer or give off markers that you're just extremely difficult to work with. But at the same time, if you're a people person with a golden liquid light levels of charisma, but you have no technical chops, that's also a non-starter. So you ideally want to land somewhere in the middle. So this leads us to the first tip. Make sure to ask your interviewer questions. People love talking about themselves. In fact, ask questions during the interview to unlock this behavioral trait. Also, if you use your questions in a wise manner, then you can use this to help you determine if the role is actually a good match for what you're looking for. Maybe you're looking to get paid upwards of 250K, but also sleep 5 hours a night and always be on call. Or maybe you're just looking for some work-life balance and you want to have a predictable routine due to other important obligations in your life. Both are fine. And both can be addressed by likely very different companies or very different teams. Now, in my personal experience, learning how to perform a specific task and learning the key problem-solving techniques to ace the coding interview are available online and abundantly present. In fact, companies like Outco teach software engineers how to solve these types of algorithms. There are also fantastic resources and books out there, including Gail Lachman McDowell's famous book, well-known among aspiring software developer engineers, Cracking the Coding Interview. In my personal opinion, I think all skills are learnable. Now, in general, most people can learn a new skill given adequate preparation, clarity, and concentration. It's usually way harder for people to radically transform their personality overnight or require more deep inner work. Let's go through an example. So I remember I interviewed two guys for an ML engineer position. Both finished great schools and had a very similar resume, but one of them was just really unpleasant and challenged everything we said. And the other one was inquisitive and also challenged us, but in a polite manner, and could have a conversation outside of just talking shop. So the job went to the second guy, because the company that I worked for was not hiring purely for aptitude, but also for an ability to work well with the team that he would be assigned to. So you never know. My advice? Check the company profile and do some research to find out what they're looking for. In fact, do research on the specific people that you will be working with, if you know. Now, the other advice for me is that many of people who want to get a job as a software developer or engineer simply do not have the proper qualifications. You could finish from MIT, UIUC, Carnegie Mellon, or Harvard, but if you can't recognize when to use Dijkstra's algorithm or how to implement a variation of it, then you're just straight out of luck. You also do not need to go to a brand name school to learn how to become a great software engineer. I've met people learning how to code while they work as food caterers for their survival job. And I've met Palo Alto housewives who have 3 kids and just have finally decided that they want a career change. I've even met people who didn't even go to traditional college or 4-year university, and some of them are the most authentic and brilliant engineers and engineering managers that I know today. So, what do we actually look for in a coding interview? Well, this leads to the next tip. Map out your thought process. Before you just dive into the code, think about writing out or diagramming your code. Now, I know, some of you that are like, no, I just want to show that I can get my feet dirty. Well, let me tell you, if you just take one moment and really read through the problem, you might catch or miss a critical feature that you looked over, because our human tendency toward heuristics will always cause you to make mental shortcuts. Now, practically speaking, if you are used to using something like CodePad, then write out some comments or skeleton code to outline your thinking process so your interviewer knows how you're thinking. If you have a whiteboard, even better. It also helps a benevolent interviewer to lightly guide you or coach you in the right direction if you seem to be veering off course. The truth is, I can't help you if I don't know where you're trying to go. In other words, make sure to map out your thought processes before you start diving into the code. At the very least, try to break down the problems first and then share with us your general approach before you begin writing your code. Finally, this leads us to point three. Communicate your thoughts. Now, of course, in an ideal setting, we want to see you write up a working solution and preferably time-optimized solution. However, situations are usually not ideal and you may not arrive at a working solution in time. Would you consider that a fail? Maybe. But on our end, that is not always a fail. In fact, what is more important is to communicate how you are thinking. Now, telepathy isn't accessible to everyone yet, so a regular interviewer can't just intuit exactly what you're thinking while you're solving a problem. Now, I'm not telling you to talk after every line that you write. That would actually be a little unnerving. I mean, I don't want you to become a chatty Cathy and then talk so much that you never finish solving the problem. However, sometimes communicating your intention and your thought process will provide us, the recruiters, with a signal about how you think. It can also help provide you with a signal about how to go in a correct direction. In particular, neuroscience research reveals that when we turn the sub-vocalization process, or mental talk, into externalized vocalization, speak talk, then people actually arrive at a solution faster. Another productivity or leadership method to practice this that many people employ is called rubber ducking. In other words, talk to the rubber duck. Talk out loud. Use spoken speech as a tool to convey where you are in the problem-solving process. And if you're about to think through something, give us a signal to know that you will be exploring such a solution. This practical tip might seem superficially basic, but you'll be so surprised at how often I get people who just feel very uncomfortable at speaking about their approach or their thinking process when they're under pressure. This is where mock interviews with friends or strangers can come really, really in handy. Remember, if you know the solution, but you can't explain your logic, the interview is basically over for you. Recruiters want to see how your brain works. Now, you can fail at arriving at the final algorithm, but if you can explain your solution and you're like 90% there, you may still actually be able to pass, depending on the company and the leniency of the hiring committee or interviewer. So remember, folks, as a software engineer, you are being hired to think about software. What does that mean? Well, while the final deliverable is working code, we also need to discover a way to assess how you think. And like I said at the beginning, I can't guess what you're thinking if you don't speak. Also, I recommend to practice algorithms daily. In one of my other videos, I actually even mentioned this. They're called code katas. And now this is one way to do it. Give yourself some time pressure and hop onto a website like HackerRank and solve one of their problems. Now, you know what they say, an apple a day keeps a doctor away? Well, this is so corny, but sometimes I like to say a kata a day keeps confusion at bay. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching this video about some unconventional tips for cracking the coding interview. If you found this video helpful, then please click like on the button below and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching and see you guys next week.